Hi guys, so Shagun here with another video from my HTC Magic. I'm gonna show you some more stuff here, like Shop Savvy. Shop Savvy is a barcode scanner. So here we go, Shop Savvy. I can search for a product. I can watch my last scans, like I have like a history. At the date at what I scanned. Here, for example, I scanned like the SpongeBob movie. Can tap here. It will give me web over 22 offers for the lowest price of $5. Local area, I have one offering for 9. I got Bewertungen, which means like comments on this video. Now let's try. Scan right away. Scan for a product. Now let's take a book here. World is flat. Here you see, it will launch like this. With the camera, now I can just hold it over the barcode. So now it recognized it. Now it's searching on the internet. Product not found in this case. Let's try the other barcode here. That's the one. Let's try this one. Oh, that was faster. Also, product not found. Weird. But as if it found, it will say, as I showed you earlier, like the price range, online and local stores which offer it, and also some comments from other posters who what they think on this book. So I showed you Shop Savvy. Now let's jump into the menu. Now what I wanted to show you else, let's go through here. I actually made a list so I don't forget. Notes, our calendar, music, oh yeah, SkyMap. SkyMap is a very cool application similar to the like Google Maps Street View. SkyMap, where are you? Right here. Now it's loading the, as the application says, the sky with the stars for you. Now it's defining my location. So here we go. Go with the stars. I can like again, like in a street view, move the phone, and it will show me the star signs and star pictures. So at night when you're like lying in the grass. On a romantic night, you can just go right here and say, oh, that's that one, that's this one. Draco right here. Don't know if you can turn off compass right here. No, you can't. You can set here different stuff, what you want to see actually. So that's very cool. Now calendar. I have here a calendar widget which shows me the next upcoming event and the current date. I can tap on it. It will launch directly into my agenda view with what's up the next days. Can also change to day view. Can like scroll here to the time, scroll here to the next day. Can see like week view. Same system here, 1 week to another. And of course, last but not least, the month view. Okay, you have to scroll like this to get to the next month. And to create a new entry, you just tap. Let's tap like here, menu, new appointment. You give the name, the date from which, what time. You can make it the whole day. Where, near description with what calendar you want to sync with. Erinnerung, which means like you want to remember. Be remembered at what time. So that's calendar. Now what else I want to show you was universal search. You have kind of use universal search on your phone. If you release the application board right there, you can release the keyboard and just start typing. It will filter your applications for you, so you don't have to flick through to find them. Even though they are here in alphabetical order, so you don't have too long, but if you have many, many applications, it can take some time till you have found one. Now what else I want to show you is Kype. Kype is also, I guess some of you know it already. So I can like go to my location or type in a place I want, search for restaurants, for pubs, for coffees, for shopping, for leisure, for hotels, everything. Let's tap for restaurants. Now it's looking restaurants in my area, because I haven't gave in a specific place. So now it's looking Cafe Bistro right here. How far away is it? Like almost a kilometer. You can flick through. Here I got ratings, and so let's tap on one of them. Here I got the exact location. I can let it view on Google Maps the distance. It's Italian food. I have one comment. So let's look what this is. Comment this. Here this guy says, okay, for 5-star rating, some text with it. Let's go here on pictures. I can add my own pictures here, but I have to register first. I can have like select more categories. So this is really great if you are like in a new city and want to know, find the next disco or a good restaurant. It's a great thing to navigate yourself through the city. Now, what else I wanted to show you? We got here music. The music application on this phone is not the best. That's why I have a replacement, TuneWiki, which I showed you in a video before. But let's show you the original music player Android comes with. Here we go. Now first you get this overview, artists, albums, titles and playlists. Let's go on artists. Here you got my interest. I just have very few songs here. Let's tap unknown artist. Now I got the different albums. Let's tap Elvis right here. Unknown album with one song. Let's tap it here. That's giving me this overview. I have no album cover, but it would show it right here. You can let the song repeat itself, and as the player is playing, you can do other things. Go in the notification bar, and there you see it's playing. Go back. So let's quit this right here. Okay, I have to go like it. Music. You can, if I go for song titles, you can play all, you can shuffle, you can create specific playlists. Okay, that's the music player for this. Now, did I forget anything? Yeah, Shazam. Flashlight, very simple application. It just turns your screen white, so if you're searching in your car or something. Where is flashlight? There we go. Just makes it white, so if you're in a dark area, it lightens a bit up. So that's kind of cool. Thank you for watching.